How's it going, guys? I'm Theo Joe, and today I've got 15 cool hidden features and settings for iPhone and iOS in general that hopefully you never heard of before. They're pretty hidden, not always well documented, but you should still find them interesting, and hopefully you'll learn something new that will be helpful. So, without further ado, let's just get started. Now, this first one is one of my favorites, and it is called Rest Finger to Open, and this will allow you to simply rest your finger on the home button or the touch sensor to unlock the phone instead of having to press the home button a second time to unlock it with the fingerprint sensor. So to do this, all you have to do is go to the settings, then general, accessibility, home button, and then enable rest finger to open. So now instead of having to press the home button or turn the power on to enable touch ID and then pressing it again to unlock, now once you press the home button, you simply kind of hold your finger there and then it will unlock the phone completely. Next up, number two, this one is new in iOS 11, and it is the ability to screen record right from the phone natively. You don't have to use any third-party apps. So to do this, it's accessible through the Control Center once you enable it. So you go to the Settings, then Control Center, Customize Control, and now you'll see the option to put the screen recording option in that Control Center. And then all you do is bring up that Control Center, tap the button, it'll give you a little countdown, and then that's how you do it. And then to stop it, you simply swipe up again to bring up the Control Center and stop it like that. Next up, number three, this one is custom vibrations per contact. So this one is really useful if you want to know immediately who's calling you just based on the vibration. So to do this, you go to the contacts list, and then you go to the person in question, and then hit edit, then go to ringtone, vibration, and then hit create new vibration. And then you can actually literally hold down and make your own custom vibration based on how you're tapping, and then it will do that whenever that person calls you. And also, here's another setting for contacts for number four. When you go to contact, then edit, you'll see one called emergency bypass. And this will allow you to let that person get through even if you have do not disturb on. Normally, if you have do not disturb enabled, that call will not go through, but if you have this enabled, then it will. So this obviously could be really useful if you're expecting a very important call, then you could set that number to come through, even if it's in the middle of the night or something. If you're on call, that would be great. All right, number five, this one I don't really think is documented anywhere. And what it is when you go into the camera app, normally, say you wanted to take a picture of a document or something, it might be hard to get it lined up perfectly straight down. Well, in the new iOS 11, when you're aiming the phone down, it will actually show you a little crosshair indicator, a white one and a yellow one, and when you line those two up, it means that your phone is completely flat. So this is a great way if you're taking a picture of a text document and you don't want it to be distorted, then this will allow you to know that you're looking straight down and you can get it undistorted. So really cool, and you might not know about. All right, next up, this one has to do with photos again, and this one is good if you tend to edit photos a lot. So this will actually allow you to duplicate photos. If you didn't know how to do this before, when you open up a photo in the app, you click the box with the up arrow, like the options button, and then kind of scroll over and you'll see an option to duplicate image. So a good reason for using this is normally when you edit a photo, like you crop it, it doesn't create a copy of the original, it just changes that photo. But maybe you want to create a cropped version and keep the original. What you could do is create a duplicate and then just edit the duplicate and then you have both. Next up, number seven. This one is gonna definitely come in handy if you didn't know about it already. And that is when you're using the keyboard and you have a lot of text and you want to put the crosshair somewhere specific, you can actually 3D touch the keyboard and then move around your finger, and it will allow you to move the crosshair in that area of text. So sometimes, you know, it's really difficult to tap in a bunch of text and get it exactly where you want, and then you have to hold it down and scroll around. But this way, if you simply 3D touch the keyboard on any character, it's a lot easier to move that crosshair around, release it, and then you're exactly where you want to be. Speaking of keyboards, this one also is great for having to do with text, and that is how you can create text replacement shortcuts. So a lot of times you may want to, I don't know, type out a phrase that you use really often, but it's kind of long. Well, this way you can go into the dictionary and add your own shortcut. So to do that, you go to the settings, then general, keyboards, text replacement. And here it will allow you to add the keyword shortcut and then what it will replace that with, or at least the option. So for example, if you want to do an emoji, like a funny face, or maybe you want to do bullet points, you could do that. And then every time you type in that phrase, it'll give you the option to select that in the text correction, and then it'll replace it with that. So you don't have to go and copy and paste it every time. Number 9, this one you're definitely going to be happy to know about, and it has to do with the calculator. So say you're in the calculator and you type in a bunch of numbers and you make a mistake in a calculation. And normally you're thinking, oh, well, I have to clear it and restart the whole thing. But no, you don't actually have to. You can actually undo a digit by simply swiping left, and it will delete the last thing you did. So next time you're doing a calculation, you screw it up, you don't have to worry about doing it all over. You can just redo that. Number 10, here's a feature with the timer you might not have known about. You can actually set the alarm of the timer to not play something, but stop playing something. So what you do is when you go into the timer, you're setting an alarm, it'll say when timer ends, and near the bottom, you can actually set it to say stop playing. So say it's at night or you're taking a nap and you're playing music when you're going to bed, but you don't want it playing all night. You can simply set a timer for an hour or so and then set to stop playing at that time, and then it will stop the music once that timer ends instead of actually playing music. So that is a nice little feature. Number 11, another good camera feature. Now, normally when you use the camera, you can kind of sort of select the exposure and the focus by tapping, but after a little while, you know it switches back to autofocus, and sometimes you don't want that. Well, here you can actually lock the autofocus and exposure by simply holding down your finger on the picture, and then it will show AEAF lock, which means autofocus, auto exposure lock, so it will not change it. So then you can just figure out what you want to do based on the composure of the image and not worry about it changing anything. Number 12, this is one you might have just figured out by yourself, but you might have noticed when using certain apps, especially if you go from one app to another via a link or something, at the top left of the phone, it'll show an arrow with the name of the last app you used. And this will actually allow you, when you tap it, to basically go back. So if you didn't mean to click a link or something that took you from Reddit to Twitter, then you can tap that and it'll take you back without having to double tap and go into the app switcher menu or anything like that. This is also good for people who usually use Android and they're used to having that back button. This basically does the same thing, although it's not always available. All right, next up, number 13. This is one I kept accidentally using without realizing it, and it's called Reachability. So if you have an iPhone 7 or later with the haptic home button, then what you can do is actually double tap the home button just by tapping it, not actually pressing in, and it will then move the window or whatever you're looking at down, which makes it easier to reach if you're using one hand. So if there's something you want to tap at the top of the screen, you can't reach it without fumbling around, you simply double tap lightly on the home button and it'll bring it down, and then you can simply press the home button again to put it back up, and then now it's a lot easier to reach. For some of you, this is probably really obvious, but I'm sure there's at least some of you like me who are relatively newer to iPhone, at least in a while, and didn't know why the heck it kept dropping down, and now you can figure it out. Number 14, this is actually kind of like multiple features in one, and it's the ability to set triple click shortcuts, and they're from the accessibility menu. So again, to get to these, you go to Settings, General, Accessibility, and then look for where it says accessibility shortcut near the bottom. Now there are a bunch of different options you can set, and you can actually set multiple of these, and then when you triple click, it will pop up a little thing to select which one you want to use. But one especially that I like, for example, is color filters. And when you enable this, you can actually customize it back in the display accommodations menu in the accessibility menu. And one example use of this is you may know the night shift feature, which dims the screen and kind of shifts it more orange at night. But maybe if you really don't like the blue light keeping you up at night, you want it to be even stronger effect. So you can use this color filters option to make it look even more red when you go into that setting for display accommodations, and then you can change the tint using a custom filter and make it more red and then increase the intensity. So then every time you triple click it, it'll make the screen look very orange or very red, which will basically make a super strong nighttime effect, which I personally like because I wish the night shift feature was even stronger, but this is kind of like a second best bet. And then also in that accessibility shortcut option, you can do ones like white point shift, which kind of dims the screen, but it's a little bit more than that. And you can also invert the colors. You can do all sorts of stuff. Again, you'll have to look those up specifically. You could probably do a whole video about those. All right, now finally, this one is kind of a feature that was hidden in plain sight. You may have never noticed it, although I believe it was introduced in iOS 10 or so. And it's called the Bedtime Mode in the Timer app. So when you go to the Timer app, right smack in the middle, it allows you to enable this mode called Bedtime Mode. And then this will allow you to basically set a wake up time and a sleep time. And then it will help you keep track of when you go to bed, when you wake up, and it will remind you a certain amount of time before you go to bed to go to sleep, and it will just help you keep on a better, more consistent sleep schedule, and then help you track when you're not doing so well. And you could also select which days you want to do it, like based on the weekend or during the week. And of course, if you want, you can customize what ringtone you want it to wake up to and everything like that. So I think that covers it. 15 cool hidden features you might not have known about in your iPhone or other iOS device. And if I missed any completely that are really awesome, of course, you can let us know down in the comments. Be sure to check down there. Some other people might know some that I didn't even mention. If you want to continue watching, I'll put some other videos right here. You can just click on those. And if you want to subscribe, I make new videos every Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday. And also be sure to enable notifications by clicking that bell next to the subscribe button, or YouTube's algorithm might not even show you new videos, even if you do subscribe. Anyway, again, I'm looking forward to hearing from you guys. Thanks so much for watching. I'll see you next time. Have a good one.